and make the travel back from the U.S. Virgin Islands, where they both took part in the Paradise Jam. Both teams went 2-1 in the tournament and look to finish up on a high note today. You're watching college basketball here on the ACC Network Extra. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. We welcome you inside the PNC Arena here in Raleigh, North Carolina, as NC State matches up with the Loyola-Chicago Ramblers in the final game of the Paradise Jam. The Wolfpack at 4-1 on the season, Loyola at 5-1. Hello, everyone. I'm Andrew Sanders alongside Chris Corciani. And Chris, Loyola off to their best start since the 2010-11 year when they started 6-0. They're led by a junior college transfer off the bench, Andre Jackson.
Okay, there's going to be some great perimeter players on the court today. Can't wait to watch them. Andre Jackson's off to a blazing start, averaging 15 points a game. But what's really amazing, he's 37 out of 47. That is the definition of being efficient.
Unreal.
But that's not a fluke because he shot 65% in junior college last year.
You saw what he did in the U.S. Virgin Islands, a career-high 22-point against St. Joe's. On the other side for the Wolfpack, they're led by the dynamite freshman point guard, Dennis Smith Jr. At his time in the U.S. Virgin Islands, all he did was manage to average 22 points.
Dennis is off to a great start. He's lived up to his billing as being one of the most spectacular players in the country. He does it all. He passes the ball, he shoots, he scores. He really lets the game come to him, and I'm really impressed with that as a freshman.
Both Jackson and Smith made to the Paradise Jam All-Tournament team. We get a look at the starting lineups for both of these schools. And Loyola, you know, a typical team that likes to spread the floor. They don't have a ton of size, but they can really shoot it.
Yeah, this is a classic mid-conference type of team where they don't have that 6'9 center that can score, but they got a number of players, 6'5, 6'6, that can all shoot the three.
For NC State, Dorn, Henderson, and Smith to go along with Abu and Anya. The first three didn't play here last year. This is a team still trying to gel, but they seem to come a long way in the U.S. Virgin Islands.
NC State's got seven new players out of their 10 that's going to play, and that's very difficult for a coach to try to make that chemistry work right away. They've gotten off to a good start, but they've got a number of other pieces that are coming here soon.
Obviously, we're not in the U.S. Virgin Islands. This game does not count towards the tournament standings, but is yet still a part of the Paradise Jam. And Malik Abu, Maurice Kirby will tip it up. Controlled by the Wolfpack, and we're underway. It's the first home game for NC State in nearly 2 weeks as they took a little break before the Paradise Jam tournament and then a few days after for Thanksgiving. Whistle before the shot from Dorn. And he must have stepped on the sideline. I was blocked out by the table. I didn't see it. Did you, Chris?
I didn't see it either, but I think that's what the call was. You know, Torn is off to a good start, shooting the ball extremely well. You know, the transfer from Charlotte.
Clayton Custer will hand off to Milton Doyle. Doyle with a little pull-up over Anya. That's tough to do, but Milton Doyle averaging nearly 15 points a game, able to knock it down.
You know, at NC State's practice, that's what they want Doyle and the rest of the Loyola players to do. They don't want to give them threes. They want to make that make contested tough twos. That was a nice shot by Doyle.
Here's Terry Henderson of NC State driving into the lane. Tough shot, got it, and the foul.
You know, Terry Henderson really shooting the ball extremely well, but it's nice to see him not settle for the jumper early. Here you see him put it on the floor and get all the way to the front of the rim, a little contact and a finish.
Henderson, too strong on the free throw. He's a good free throw shooter, but can't convert the three-point play. We're all tied up at two, and here come the Ramblers. It's Ben Richardson, guarded by Henderson. Richardson lost the handle, and it's picked up by Dennis Smith. NC State loves to get out and run. Here's a spot-up three for Henderson, and it's good.
Great look by Dennis, under control on the break, and finds Terry Henderson on the wing. That's what NC State wants to do. They want to defend, rebound, and run.
Terry Henderson red hot in the Paradise Jam. He continues that here back at home. Better than 40% on the year from deep. Little shot fake from Custer. He'll put up the floater and finish.
It's a nice shot by Custer. He got Dennis Smith up in the air, one dribble, and finishes in the lane. He's a real nice player, a transfer from Iowa State.
Gets it to Abu on the pick and roll, but Abu couldn't finish. Boarded up by Maurice Kirby. We talked about their size. Kirby, the tallest player at 6'9" on the court for Loyola. Custer sealed off, gets it away to his high school teammate Richardson from the elbow. And so far, Loyola is showing an ability to get towards the paint, Chris.
You know, that's exactly what NC State wanted to give them, but they don't want to make it too easy on them. In practice yesterday, Coach Godfrey reiterated, we're not going to give them threes. We want to give them contested twos. Early on, they haven't been contested.
Henderson fading away, last touched. It'll be Loyola ball. And the first substitute of the game will be Markel Johnson in for B.J. Anya. So here is Mark Gottfried's smaller lineup.
This is a lineup he likes a lot. You know, this is a good defensive lineup. They can really run with this lineup. The one thing that hurts them with this lineup is defensive rebounding. They gave up 22 offensive boards to St. Joe's. So that's the concern with playing this smaller lineup.
Richardson for three. Splash! And just like that, it's 9-5 Ramblers.
Loyola under control, really playing smart.
Tough finish for Dorn, and he couldn't. The rebound goes to Dante Ingram into the ball game. All the way to the rim, it's Doyle. Basket in the foul, pardon me. Got a little excited there, Chris. It was a good finish.
I tell you, they came to the PNC to play. Loyola's off to a good start. They've got great spacing on that break. As you see him coming down, all their shooters flared to the wings and created Doyle a driving lane to the middle. But NC State's got to do a much better job of getting back on defense.
Loyola, a perfect 5 of 5 from the floor thus far. Doyle is a senior from Chicago. Voted preseason second team All-MVC in Missouri Valley. Abu will grab the errant free throw. So 3 minutes in, Ramblers by 6. And Abu turns it over. 0 guarding 0. Ingram picks up his dribble. Richardson's had the hot hand early here. Over Henderson, not this time. And there's the size from Abu, just able to play volleyball with it until he could finally corral it.
Abu's got size and athleticism and just plays a little volleyball to get the rebound.
Long three from Smith, missed it a bit short.
So I've been real impressed with the Loyola's patience on the offensive end. They had a little blow by on defense. Mark Godfrey can't be happy with this early start for NC State.
Yeah, already Milton Doyle able to slip into the lane a couple of times. Crowd trying to get behind the Wolfpack here as it's an 8-point Rambler advantage. Custer marking Smith one-on-one. He bumped him. Foul on the floor. And we will take a timeout on the floor as well for the under 16. How about Milton Doyle and Loyola? They came ready to play this afternoon in the PNC. Loyola-Chicago leads NC State by 8 here in the early going, being led by the 6'4 senior guard Milton Doyle. He already has 6 of the 13 Rambler points. And as you can see, averaging nearly 15 a game, he has been tremendous, able to get into the lane here.
I tell you, he does it inside, outside. There he did it on the break, always under control. Just a really nice player.
Doyle scored double figures in each of his last 7 games dating back to last year, so already well on his way to that mark. Ted Capita is in for NC State, finds Terry Henderson. Tough shot, and he got it.
I tell you, Capita did a real nice job. He got double teamed, took a dribble step out to find the open man.
And Henderson has all 7 of NC State's points. They double Richardson. Three on the way is knocked down by Andre Jackson. He continues the torrid shooting pace.
It's amazing. His percentages are just out of this world. And it's not all dunks or layups. I mean, he does it all so many different ways.
Hey, Terry Henderson already in the double figures just 5 minutes into the game.
Tell you, he shot the ball extremely well in a couple games on the Virgin Islands. He kept us in it. Against Creighton, he was really tremendous, just shooting the ball at a high level.
Ball knocked away by Dennis Smith. Last touch by Smith.
NC State needs to play defense for longer periods of time. They're good for 5, 10, 15 seconds, but they've got to really hunker down on the defensive end.
Richardson, junior from Overland Park, Kansas. Not in there with Clayton Custer right now. His high school teammate Ingram will try a three. Loyola continues to remain on fire, 8 of 9 from the floor.
Yeah, NC State went to a little zone there to try to throw him off. Again, Loyola with great ball movement, found the open man.
Johnson a bit too strong. What a rebound by Capita, but he's over the back. That'll be his first.
That's the kind of effort you want to see. I mean, that's a kid out there that is going after the ball. You know, he wants minutes, and Ted Capita gives NC State that fiery player that they need. Unfortunately, went over the back.
He's glad to be back on the court. Could not make the trip to the U.S. Virgin Islands. Another three, and finally one doesn't go down for the Ramblers.
He doesn't miss many.
That was the concern, really, for Mark Gottfried and the Wolfpack, is this is a team that can very well shoot you out of a zone, as there's a pretty pass into Johnson on the cut.
Great pass. I tell you, those two guards work really well together. They're both point guards, but it makes NC State a very explosive team when they're on the court together.
Jackson will hand off to Richardson. Dennis Smith already with three assists in this contest. Ingram lost it. It'll stay here.
I tell you, Dennis really has great hands. Here you see him penetrating a little back door, but you know, you got to give a lot of credit to Markel Johnson. He's reading exactly what Dennis is doing. And the nice finish. You're going to see a lot of those two play together this year, Markel Johnson and Dennis Smith.
Ingram open for three. Back iron. Custer backpedaling. Smith Jr. will drive right at him. Kiss it off the glass with the left hand.
Well, that's the strength that Dennis Smith has. You know, a lot of guards, they get bumped and they're not able to finish like that. Dennis takes a little bump and still is able to finish.
Look at the lineup on the court right now for NC State. All five of these guys not here last season. Doyle double teamed. Trying to reverse the ball, tapped away by Dennis Smith. And an assist for my partner here to the referee.
Got a little ball time. I'll tell you what, I wanted to try to throw up a half-court shot. I don't know if that would have gone over real well.
11 on the shot clock here. Custer directing traffic. Got to get something up. And it missed everything.
That was a good defensive possession there by NC State. Stayed focused, made them take a tough shot that was contested.
And that's kind of like what you were getting to earlier, right? They need to play defense for longer periods. They played for the entire duration of the shot clock.
And I think this team early on in the season, they like the offensive end a lot better. But when you get into games that really matter and ACC games, you know, you're really going to win it on the defensive end. And they just need to learn that, and I'm sure they'll be fine.
That's going to be the second foul on Capita. And both of them trying to go after an offensive rebound. It's a good look to Abu.
Yeah, he just needs to learn. You know, just you want to see that aggressive action by Capita, but he just needs to learn to pick and choose when he's going to, you know, do that. You know, right now they're a little thin up front, you know, with Omer Yurtseven out.
Jackson backing down Capita. Now he'll kick. Richardson will try a three. He hits.
It was a nice kick from the big man to the guard outside to find the open shooter.
He's got 8. Loyola 4 of 7 from beyond the arc. As Torin Dorn will come in, I assume it'll be Kapita coming out, and it will be. Ben Richardson led the Missouri Valley Conference last year, shot 44% from three-point range. He's just a hair under that coming into this game as Smith walked with a basketball.
Tell you, Loyola's got to be really happy with an eight-point lead. The game is settling in a little bit. They're on the offensive end, they're moving the ball, getting a lot of action. Defensively, they're playing hard and solid. It'll be interesting to see if they make any adjustments, NC State, on the defensive end.
Dorn got a hand in there to break it up. Three on the way, and that's good. It's the freshman, Cameron Satterwhite. 5 of 8 from downtown now.
You know, they average 24 attempts a game, and they can shoot it. And that was the concern going into the game early.
It'll stay down on this end, and that'll take us to the under 12 timeout. It's an 11-point lead for the Loyola-Chicago Ramblers as they've already knocked down 5 threes. Here's Satterwhite to put them up 11. Back here in Raleigh, I'm Andrew Sanders alongside Chris Corciani. Loyola-Chicago with an 11-point advantage of the second media timeout. Chris, you see, this is a team very confident in their ability to shoot, and they're outdoing even themselves today at 71%.
I mean, it's remarkable. You know, for the year, 51% is great, but they're blazing early on. NC State needs to put a little bit more pressure on their shooters. It's just too easy for them.
Terry Henderson has had the hot hand for the Wolfpack. He has 10 of their 14. And he misses a long three, rebounded by Richardson. There's the freshman, Bruno Skokna, the Croatian. And a turnover. Dorn, the Euro step, that's pretty.
So he's just a great athlete. That's every team's best offense, is creating a turnover, a steal, a long rebound, getting out and running. And NC State doesn't want to set up on offense. You know, they're much better off getting out and running and getting some good shots.
Richardson had a challenge shot that time. Dennis Smith. Oh, a quick look inside. Abu couldn't handle it.
Ah, it was a great pass by Dennis, but Malik wasn't able to corral it and take advantage of it.
We told you he's already got three assists. Got to be ready for the basketball as that one's finished inside.
You know, that's the problem. You know, in talking with Mark earlier today, was this small lineup, those type of things are tough.
Markel Johnson to Dennis Smith Jr.
I'll tell you, Dennis gave him a nice pass earlier in the game, and Markel returning the favor.
Tell you what, Markel Johnson, that's already his 18th assist of the season. Richardson had it poked away, regathered, and the rebound will come to Dennis Smith. Missed by Vlatko Granic. Quick shot.
Quick shot. Tell you what, they're the ones that Coach Gottfried gives him a green light on because he is the star. Here you see him splitting the pick and roll. Nice pass to Dennis Smith. They're on a roll.
That's what I was thinking, is that, you know, normally if you're on a little bit of a run like that, you probably don't want a long two-point shot in that position that early in the shot clock. But it's one of those, I guess, if he makes it, it's fine.
That's right. You know, I think Dennis's light is very green. When I was playing, mine was like a red light.
Yeah.
But Coach Gottfried has a lot of trust in Dennis's ability, and he knows he's the kind of player that can string together 6-8 points and really put the team on his back.
Smith already with 6 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists in this one. You see what the trio of Smith, Henderson, and Dorn have done this year.
It's amazing. They're all great athletes. They all shoot at a very high percentage. Torin Dorn's the one who's really surprised me. Plays both ends of the court, very tough. you know, just a solid player.
Doyle goes in amongst the trees and finds a wide open Maurice Kirby.
There's got to be some weak side help. Anybody on the weak side needs to pin back down. And real, that's what we call help defense.
Dennis Smith Jr. is feeling it right now.
He's the guy that can put NC State on its back at any time. You know, down seven, NC State's going to need more of that here in the first half.
Custer, I think, was looking for a screen. Instead, he'll give it up to Kirby. Kirby screens for Doyle. Tough shot, falling away. Front iron, no good. The Rambler lead is seven. Dorn draws all kinds of attention, and who got him? It was either Kirby or Doyle, and it will be Milton Doyle with the foul.
Torin Dorn's just a very smart player here. Here you see Dennis just baking, shaking, doing it all. Knocks down the 15-footer. He's playing with great confidence early on, but Torin Dorn, really smart. He knew that two players were in the air, and he was able to create contact.
Dorn makes the first. Just over halfway through this first half, and Chris, we've already been treated to some hot shooting by both teams. Loyola's now down to 60%. NC State is up to 59%.
That's big time shooting, even if no one's guarding you. But you got great athletes out there running around. You know, I doubt that that will continue the rest of the game, but both teams are off to a hot shooting start.
So Dorn makes both free throws. Half court pressure from the Wolfpack. Ingram got into some trouble. They worked the ball around. Custer with an open three. Good.
Tell you, credit Loyola. That's just great ball movement. Three or four passes. The ball went inside, outside, and they're really sharing the basketball.
Henderson will try to match. Back iron rebounded by Custer. Custer, a junior from Overland Park, Kansas. Sat out last year due to transfer rules after coming over from Iowa State. He did play sparingly as a freshman. Jackson, you know he's going to make it. Almost an 80% shooter on the season, and I would suppose that he's above 80 with that shot now.
Amazing. Amazing his numbers, but NC State went to zone that time, and they just moved the ball to the short corner, found Jackson.
B.J. Anya missed it short. Had a good move and a look at the basket. And you can see the size advantage down there, but so far hasn't mattered for Loyola at all. Dorn will try a three. And he continues to shoot well. He's kind of the Andre Jackson of NC State. He's shooting better than 63%.
I'll tell you, the coaching staff at NC State really worked on his shot all summer. They wanted him to get more lift and elevation on his shot, and it surely has helped him.
Good feed to Jackson, and he'll get a foul as well.
Credit Richardson there. You know, good head fake, couple dribbles, and the dish to Jackson.
So NC State's Dennis Smith Jr. starting to heat up in this ballgame, but Loyola able to score with such efficiency, already 36 points, and they lead the Wolfpack by nine as we head to break. Loyola with an opportunity to stretch this lead to 10 on a free throw from Andre Jackson. Just over 7 minutes to go here in the first half. I'm Andrew Sanders alongside Chris Corciani. Chris, we talked about this briefly so far, but three starters from Loyola have transferred in from Power 5 schools, Custer, Doyle, and Kirby. You know they've got to have a little juice going when they go up against the Power 5 school.
There's no question. It's a great advantage for mid-majors. You know, you get certain guys that go to bigger programs that don't get the time they want, and they transfer down a level because they want to play. So an opportunity like this today is special, especially to those three players we just had up on the monitor.
So Loyola leads by 10. 15 to shoot. Dennis Smith Jr. already has 8 for the Wolfpack. Clearing everything out. Tough shot. And missed the front of the rim, and Abu will be called for an offensive foul. Going after the rebound again. We've seen that now, two on Kapita. And Abu picks up the foul. That's his second.
It was great effort by NC State and Abu. Hey, Loyola's doing a remarkable job of really putting their body and boxing out. And there you see Abu wanted to get it, but he was boxed out by the smaller Loyola defender.
Yeah, NC State does not have an offensive rebound yet. And that's got to be part of the reason that in the hot shooting, why Loyola has managed to get up double digits here. That's a poor pass from Doyle. Didn't use the screen from Anil. He'll go to the rim. And he will be two shots for Dennis Smith Jr. Thought it might have been a tie up there.
You know, again, he's very elusive. Great first step. There you see him. Finds contact, splits the two of them. He's just a special player that when he gets it going, he's hard to stop.
The second foul on Doyle, so he'll go take a seat on the bench. Right now, Custer, Richardson, Jackson. As he misses the free throw, Ingram and Skokna.
Tell you, these next 6 minutes are really crucial for Loyola. They want to be able to stay right where they are going into the second half.
Another open three, not this time. Skokna can really knock those down. And right now, this Wolfpack defense, I mean, we're talking about Loyola's hot shooting, and part of that is them, but boy, they're getting an awful lot of good looks at the basket.
Yeah, they need to kind of buckle up, make some adjustments the second half.
Anya goes strong, and again, he misses it short side. With Abu and Capita on the bench with those two fouls, NC State needs him to be able to score against this smaller lineup for Loyola.
He's had two nice looks. He just hasn't been able to finish.
He'll board the Ingram miss here.
Oh, beautiful.
What a pretty move for Dorn.
Change of direction, stutter step. Dorn has that in his arsenal. I'll tell you, NC State's at its best when they're in transition and creating for one another. They need to work on their half-court offense.
Anya got knocked down and might have gotten hit as Hicks will come in. He lost a contact.
Fell back. Hopefully BJ's all right.
So he'll come out. Hicks will come in. Darius Hicks is the freshman. We'll see. Again, it happened away from the ball. And he lost a contact and couldn't see. He just said, get me out of there. Custer. Well, that looked like a clean block. Johnson didn't get him with the body.
I think he got him on the arm. He just swatted up. I tell you, it was a great move by Custer. Under control. Knew Johnson was coming up behind him. Just a smart play.
As Custer misses the free throw, the 78% shooter on the year is Custer. Big-time recruit, top 100 recruit, Gatorade player of the year in high school in Kansas. Three times All-State, but Iowa State just didn't work out for him. And as we've talked about, you know, you can get an opportunity to play some big minutes somewhere else. Why not take advantage of it? He's made the most of his opportunity his first year playing for Loyola. Averaging better than 13 points a game.
NC State, they want a couple buckets. They want to try to close the gap. Loyola, they want to finish out the great first half that they've started.
NC State will take that look from Terry Henderson. 12 of the Wolfpack's 32 now. Mark Gottfried has said he has a calming effect on the team. He's one of the leaders despite not being able to play last year or the year before. Skokna all the way to the rim, and he blew the layup.
Here's where they're at their best. Dennis with the ball, finding the right man.
And that's a blocking foul. It'll go against Custer, and that is his second foul.
Here you see the pass. That's a little bang, bang. I think NC State may have gotten away with one there. I think the other, Roger Ayers, caught a block, and I believe the referee from midcourt was coming in. But Roger Ayers probably has a little higher rank than him. And luckily for NC State.
I saw the same thing you did. The other official, I think, was looking to call it, but deferred. Henderson, two more.
Boy, he's on fire. Tell you, when he gets it going like he did down in the Virgin Islands, he is tough to stop. And he's off to a blazing first half.
And the crowd gets loud now as the Pack have cut it to four. Satterwhite just glides all the way to the rim.
I mean, you just can't get beat off the dribble and finish at the rim without anybody contesting. Mark Gottfried not happy with that defensive possession.
They really like the athleticism that Satterwhite brings. And he kind of shows it off there. Little back cut. Throw it down, Terry Henderson.
What a great look by Dennis Smith. Great movement by Terry Henderson. Dennis has had two or three of those passes here in the first half. Very impressive.
And a couple of back cuts. Satterwhite can't get all the way to the rim this time, but he finds a wide open Richardson.
You know, again, an uncontested three. Ball movement, Loyola doing a great job of finding the open shooter, but NC State needs to figure out why they're getting so wide open.
7-point lead, there's Smith. Boy, both teams back and forth. We have been treated to a good game so far.
We haven't
seen, you know, some of the stoppages that we typically have seen in the early juncture of the season. A lot of flow to this one. A lot of back and forth. Henderson. Boy, you could hear him hit the ball out of Richardson's hands for here from the table. NC State has cut it to five. Terry Henderson carrying the Wolfpack. He scored their last six and throws down the flush. Welcome you back to the PNC Arena. Tuesday at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN, we'll have number 24 Michigan State and number 6 Duke in the ACC Big Ten Challenge from Cameron Indoor. Coach K is 8-1 against Tom Izzo and the Spartans. It's also streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. Foul underneath, and it's Andre Jackson.
I'll tell you, they're two Hall of Fame coaches going at one another, Tom Izzo and Coach K. That's got to be a great battle every time those two teams with those two coaches step on the floor.
First free throw, no good. It's NC State has led for just 52 seconds of this first half. As you said, it's critical for Loyola to finish it out. They led by, largest lead was 11 points, and not making free throws from Jackson. If NC State can cut this lead before halftime, and Smith just won't get the roll.
Good move, good look. Dennis' shot just didn't fall.
It's Smith on Richardson. Under 10 to shoot, Richardson. Probing into the lane, throws up the left-handed shot, no good. Well defended by Markel Johnson, and again, here's Dorn, and a blocking foul. And that's a good call. You could see him kind of leaning, had position initially.
Tell you, he needs to stand in there and take it. You can see he's got good position, just leaning a little to the side and back. The referee's not going to give him that call. So Richardson had a real nice move on the other end, but just didn't finish with his left. Would have been a big basket for Loyola with a little under 2 minutes to go.
Thorn hits the first. He's got 9 points, now 10, pardon me, with that free throw. Henderson has 16, Dennis Smith with 11. And out of those 39 points, only two coming from someone other than those three. Two by Markel Johnson. So we talked about how important the trio are, but they need some help.
That's a blessing and a curse at the same time. You're happy they're carrying NC State, but they need to find more balanced attack. And the one they really need to get it from is Malik Abu. Malik, with only 8 minutes in the first half and two shots, they've got to find a way to get him going in the second half.
Wolfpack have cut it to three. Custer picked up the basketball. And that was nearly dangerous, but credit the senior Doyle to go and help him out. Eight to shoot. Marked by Hicks. And his shot was blocked by Henderson. Here comes the pack in transition. Henderson a pull-up. Too strong. You can start to feel the energy in this building as NC State went on that fast break. And here's a turnover from the Ramblers.
That's what they need to do. I think last defensive possession NC State had, you could tell they were focused. They were, you know, really ready to play. But we haven't seen that for the first 19 minutes of the first half. They're going to have to come out the second half with that same energy on the defensive end.
Loyola, no points over the last 2:15 and counting.
They're sitting in a little 3-2 zone. They've been man-to-man most of the game, just switching it up a little bit.
A different look right before halftime. Dennis Smith, tough shot. A little scoop.
Dipsy-doo. I tell you, he's got a little bit of everything in his arsenal.
Loyola leads by one. About a 5-second differential between shot clock and game clock. Got ourselves a high-scoring first half. We expected that. Both these teams score into the 80s, and certainly on pace to do that here. And an offensive foul.
A good call. Terry Henderson trying to fight through the screen. An illegal block. This isn't the way Coach Mosier wanted to finish out the first half with a 7-8 point lead with 3 minutes to go. NC State certainly has turned it on.
No, the Wolfpack in Coach Gottfried will call a timeout here. 17 seconds remaining in the first half. You saw the pretty finish from Dennis Smith. He now has 13. By the way, that foul went against number 14, Ben Richardson. Just his first foul. But NC State with an opportunity, go ahead and use this timeout, get something out of it, a good look, plenty of time to do so. And, you know, as hot as Loyola started this game, and they're still shooting 55%, Chris, NC State with an opportunity to still have the lead at halftime.
Yeah, that's, you know, shooting 55% in the game. Usually you shoot 55, 60%, you're up 10 points. In that huddle, I'm sure Coach Gottfried drew up a play. I would think Dennis Smith would be involved in this play, but he also wants to make sure that they get the last shot. They don't want to shoot the ball with 10 seconds, 8 seconds. They don't want to give Loyola an opportunity for a shot.
Do you like to give yourself a couple of seconds just for an offensive rebound opportunity?
You do, but certainly not enough. And that's the kind of thing with a young team, you know, that's what he was emphasizing.
Wide open under the basket is Markel Johnson. It's good if it goes. Oh, Richardson almost knocked it down. NC State closes the first half on an 8-0 run, and they will take a one-point lead into the locker room. So for Loyola, they've got to feel, you know, great about the way that they played and competed in that first half, but yet they were up by 11. It's got to be a little bit demoralizing to go in trailing now.
There's no question. You know, you can tell the momentum changed the second part of that first half. You know, they shot the ball extremely well, Loyola did, but they really don't have a whole lot to show for it. You know, they're going to have to come out and really establish themselves early in the second half.
All right, we'll hit the halftime locker room. We'll be back in a couple of minutes from the PNC. NC State leads by one. Back here in the PNC Arena, NC State leads Loyola 44-43 at the halftime break. Hello, everybody. We welcome you courtside here in the PNC. I'm Andrew Sanders alongside Chris Corciani. And, Chris, it was an up-and-down first half for Loyola. What do they need to do in the second half? I know they had some success up 11 at one point, but to see it all go away there at the end, what do they need to change?
I think on the offensive end they were fine. They shot at a high percentage. They moved the ball. They got good action. It's on the defensive end that they need to find a way to contain Terry Henderson and Dennis Smith. They really hurt them. Maybe they go a triangle and two. Maybe they really put more pressure on them. But it was really on the defensive end that they need to make some adjustments.
Yeah, we saw NC State with Henderson and Dorn and Dennis Smith Jr. just really take over the latter half of that first half and let NC State, you know, on an 8-0 run to end the break.
Yeah, no question. Those guys got out of the gates, had a great first half. NC State, on the other hand, they've got to make some adjustments at halftime. You know, they were down 11 early. They started playing with more energy, more aggression, and that's what you're going to have to see here in the second half right away, because this is the team, Loyola, you don't want to fall behind to
right.
them with great shooters, some experienced players. Could be a long day for us.
Well, this is the final game of the Paradise Jam. We're looking forward here just a little bit to the ACC Big Ten Challenge presented by LG V20. If you look at this, NC State at Illinois Tuesday night on ESPNU. But as always, ACC Big Challenge, Big Ten Challenge, such a treat for just college basketball fans. So many good matchups.
It's great. It's fun to watch. It's fun for the players. It's fun for the spectators. You know, you're going up against teams that you generally don't play.
Yeah.
They keep score. They tally who's going to win. The ACC leads the series, as you see. I'm very proud of that, 10-5-2. But it's just a fun few days of basketball.
It's hard to believe the ACC won the first 10 and then haven't won one outright since 2008. Many people think that the Atlantic Coast Conference is the best conference in college basketball this year. Perhaps they will end that run this year. We'll have to find out. We'll take a break here at halftime. Again, our score, NC State 44, Loyola 43. Halftime here between NC State and Loyola. I'm Andrew Sanders with Chris Corciani. Glad you could join us here on the ACC Network Extra. The Wolfpack lead it by just one at the halftime break. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half action. And for Loyola, we knew about Clayton Custer and Ben Richardson coming in. These two played together 4 years in high school. They have been quite a combination in the first half, Chris.
They know each other extremely well. There you see a little dribble penetration, the pull up. They did a good job of moving the ball and moving their bodies. There you see a nice screen for a bucket, dribble drive, shot there. You know, they just had a really nice rhythm, especially early in the first half.
11 points for Richardson, 6 for Custer. And then for NC State, the game's high scorer so far, Terry Henderson. And he's able to score it really in spurts.
Yeah, he scores in spurts. He's a great shooter. You know, did some nice things mid-range as well. But they need help. Somebody has to step up on the interior to give them some kind of different look. You know, right now their best offense in the first half has been when they get the ball and go, a lot of one-on-one. They need to find that inside guy, and it's got to be Malik Abu.
Terry Henderson leads all scorers with 16 points. The most fancy of his points right there. You take a look at the stats from the first half, a very even field goal percentage, but Loyola, they average just better than 8 threes per contest. They've already knocked down 7.
Yeah, it's amazing. They're shooting the ball extremely well, and so is NC State. So both these teams on the offensive end don't want to change a whole lot of what they're doing. I guarantee you, in the locker room right now, you've got both coaches saying, listen, this game is not going to be won at the offensive end. It's going to be won at the defensive end.
All right. We'll hit the halftime break once more. Be back in just a couple of minutes here from Raleigh. NC State leads by 1. Next Sunday, we'll have the College Football Playoff Selection Show, a 4-hour special to exclusively reveal the College Football Playoff semifinal matchups in the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl and PlayStation Fiesta Bowl on December 31st. Reese and the gang will also unveil the other New Year's Six bowl games and have the final top 25 rankings. It all starts at noon Eastern on ESPN and is also available streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. Alongside Chris Corciani, I'm Andrew Sanders. Chris, keys to the second half, first for the Ramblers.
The Ramblers need to continue, much like they did the first half, good movement on the offensive end, try to go to the offensive glass. But on the defensive end, that's where they really need to make some adjustments. They need to be able to stop NC State's perimeter, let their bigs kind of help out a little bit more. That'll be the big adjustment for them on the offensive and defensive end.
And as we spoke about earlier, NC State, they have just 4 points off the bench, need to get some help there. There's the head coach of the Ramblers, Porter Moser, in his 6th season. This is a matchup of a couple of 6th-year head coaches. A couple of years ago, he led Loyola to the CBI Tournament Championship, and that was their first postseason appearance in 30 years. A bit of a down year last year, but this is a team that was picked 7th in the Missouri Valley. They've got some really good talent.
I tell you, Coach Moser's done a great job while he's been there, like you said, a couple years ago, he had a really good team last year, down year, but they were rebuilding. They had transfers that were sitting out.
Right.
And I tell you, the Missouri Valley is a very difficult conference with Wichita State, Northern Iowa, Southern Illinois, and he's done a remarkable job.
Looking for a Power 5 win here today for Mark Gottfried, sporting the beard here in the month of November, his sixth year in Raleigh, and this has got to be his most talented team.
Oh, no question. There's plenty of talent on the floor this year. You know, Mark's done a tremendous job in 5 years. You know, they've gone to two Sweet 16. They've gone to the NCAA tournament just about every year. There's great excitement behind this team, and they've done a great job of recruiting big-time talent. There you see Orlando Early and Coach Heath. They've got a great coaching staff that really works hard on the recruiting trail.
NC State men's basketball staff, by the way, as you saw the beards over on the bench, not shaving in the month of November in support of Chris Combs, a former NC State baseball player and current associate director of the Wolfpack Club, who was diagnosed with ALS in May. So it's a great way for them to show their support and to help raise awareness. And if you would like to help in the fight against ALS, as a walking call is going to go against Ingram, you can tweet and share on social media using the hashtag Beards4, the number 4, Beards4ChrisALS, or you can visit TeamChrisCombs.com.
I tell you, it's a great cause. I think the coaching staff showing a great class in doing that. Chris Combs is a wonderful person, a great family. His wife's wonderful, his kids. Very sad, but I tell you what, nobody loves NC State more than Chris Combs and his family.
Terry Henderson with the finger roll, and he'll head to the free throw line, and he picks up right where he left off in the first half.
Great move. That's really nice to see Terry not settling for a jumper, slashing, getting to the lane. You know, a lot of times when you're a great shooter, sometimes that's all you do. But Terry's really worked on his game, and there you see him putting it on the deck and finishing at the rim.
Now 19 points for Terry Henderson.
Interesting to see NC State here picking up full court. I think the adjustment they're making is they want more intensity. Markell Johnson gets to start the second half. That means they really want to go to their fast, explosive lineup.
You saw Johnson was tough drive by Custer, missed it. Abu reestablished himself back in bounds. That's fine. Hey, Custer was really being bothered there by Johnson on the inbounds. As a point guard, how frustrating can that be when they're guarding you the length of the court and it's just hard to get the basketball?
Oh, yeah, it makes it tough. You know, it throws you out of rhythm. You know, point guards want to be able to bring the ball up the court without being harassed. I hated when guys were bothering me. Here you see a nice pass into Abu. Be nice to see him make a couple free throws here and get him going for NC State.
Malik Abu was awfully quiet in the first half. He had those two fouls. Severely limited his minutes. That's his first point of the game. And Abu played just 8 minutes in the first half.
Right. You know, they weren't real happy with his production, his effort. But here you see him getting a free throw to go down. A lot of times that's what you need for a player, just to see the ball go in the basket. But they're going to try to do it with a little bit of pressure or speed the game up a little bit.
Because when we talk about Malik Abu, we're talking about a double-doubles machine. He has 18 in his career, and you would think against an undersized team, this is where he would really shine, but wasn't the case in the first half as Henderson just did step on the sideline.
I tell you, Henderson's playing both ends of the floor here. There you see him almost with a near steal, but no doubt the game plan for NC State was to speed him up and really try to play aggressive defense here early in the second half.
They do seem to be playing with a different intensity already. Johnson all over Custer. 12 on the shot clock. Doyle looking inside. You got to feed the big man that's shooting 79%. Instead, he'll take a fall away and missed it.
You know, again, we talked about this early in the broadcast. Mark Gottfried loves this small lineup, but the one thing they need to do, you know, you look at Abu, basically he's the biggest guy out there, and Terry Henderson would be the power forward of this group, so they need to rebound as a pack. Uh-oh, here we go.
Poor pass. Richardson's back, and Smith just blows by him for the lay-in.
But that's a poor – I'd feel bad for anybody when Dennis Smith is coming at you one-on-one. Boy, the best thing to do is just duck and get out of the way.
We'll head to break as Loyola wants timeout. Dennis Smith Jr., something to behold on the fast break. Back here in Raleigh, NC State on a 15-0 run here that dates back to the first half. And, Chris, the biggest difference for you, I know, has been that defense.
Yeah, it's the energy. It's the will. It's the want. It's picking up full court. Markel Johnson, Dennis Smith, and the big guys, everybody else, seeing the effort that they're putting in.
Henderson called for a foul. It's Jackson down low. That's the second foul on Henderson. It was 40-36
Wow. When
Ben Richardson made the three-pointer to stretch the lead to seven. And then before this bucket from Jackson, it had been a 15-0 run. Jackson will complete the three-point play.
Tell you, Loyola needed that little three-point play just to kind of stop the bleeding.
Dorn will step into a three, in and out.
You know, Loyola needs to do what they did the first half, be patient, pass the ball, move, cut. It's a good offensive possession right there.
And a nice shot from Custer. His freshman year at Iowa State, he appeared in 12 games, averaged just 6 minutes, and scored just better than 1 point per contest. Seeing a much bigger role here at Loyola. Last touch by Malik Abu.
Okay, nice look. Henderson took the ball on the baseline, scooped it to Malik, but he couldn't finish.
So after that timeout, good timeout by Coach Moser. Loyola has looked more focused. You know, they turned the ball over just five times in the first half and had committed two in just a minute and 30 of the second half.
Right. Markel Johnson applying great pressure. Custer, he couldn't even get the ball in the backcourt to get them going. My credit, I give all the credit to Markel Johnson. He wouldn't let Custer get the ball. Then you've got a guy trying to get into the offense that generally doesn't and creates a turnover. Good job, Markel Johnson.
When the point guard doesn't touch the ball, the turnovers are going to go up a little bit. Dennis Smith is the NC State point guard. All by himself.
Tell you, you can see a look in his eye that he really wants to go, wants to take over. And when he has that as a defender, that's not a good thing.
And that is what NC State fans have wanted to see. And they've seen it more gradually throughout the year. A player that was, you know, preseason freshman of the year in the ACC and named first team preseason all ACC. Custer gets the ball this time. His first touch in a while, but he misses. Richardson is taking the responsibility of guarding Dennis Smith. Thorne with a tough look inside. The ball will stay on this side with 18 to shoot for NC State.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, you got to give Dennis Smith a lot of credit. You know, coming in, heralded as one of the great freshmen in the country, he's let the game come to him. He hasn't forced a lot of action, and he really is playing well within the system.
Skokna back in for the Ramblers. Smith will try a three. He's 8 of 12 from the field, including that miss, with 17 points. Ingram will turn over that right shoulder.
It's a great move by Ingram. Took the ball hard on a nice dribble drive. Then he stopped, collected himself, and came back with the little hook.
Henderson able to tap it out to Markel Johnson, an athletic play, nearly a turnover. Boyle has cut it to three. Here's the lob, and too far out for Henderson.
I tell you, those last three NC State possessions were not good possessions. A lot of one-on-one basketball.
So we'll head to break. NC State had raced out to an eight-point lead, but Loyola reeling them back in. They trail by three. NC State's Dennis Smith Jr. has been very assertive here in this afternoon's ball game. Already 17 points, Chris.
Yeah, he can do a little bit of everything, but here in the second half, he's trying to take over, put NC State on his back. Yeah, that pressure that NC State came out with in the second half certainly has created a problem for Loyola. Loyola needs to just kind of slow down, calm down, and do what they did early on with a lot of dribble penetration and movement.
Oh, good look inside by Richardson as he finds Jackson. And if you find him with a pass like that, that would help, you know, explain why he's shooting 80% on the year.
Well, that's a great look by Richardson. Got great deep penetration and kicked it to the guy who he knows can put it through the basket as good as anyone.
Dorn looking to move one-on-one. All the way to the rack, it rolls off. Tipped by Abu, no good. Custer is fouled by Dorn.
I tell you, the last few possessions NC State has had is a lot of one-on-one, not really moving the ball. They need to make Loyola play a little bit of defense. Throw the ball side to side. Some quick shots, that's what Loyola wants. It's easy to play defense if you're going down there shooting quick. Make Loyola work a little bit.
Little cheer here in the crowd for Ted Capita as Henderson comes out. Capita's played just 4 minutes thus far. He picked up two quick fouls, trying to offensively rebound the ball. We've also just received word. Remember, BJ Anya went out. We thought he lost a contact, had a problem with his eyes. He just fell down on the floor to get himself out of there. He has been cleared to come back, we've been told. There's a big block by Abu, and this turns into a transition bucket. Johnson to Smith.
Make no mistake about that. That was a pass all the way. Markel Johnson saw Dennis Smith, threw it out there. But a great hit-ahead pass by Dennis Smith to get that going.
How about this combo of freshman guards for Mark Godfrey?
There they go. Well, I tell you, he makes it look so easy. He just slithers in there, glides, finishes with his left hand. Just a real special player.
Markel Johnson and Dennis Smith, you know, it's tough to be a freshman point guard, especially in the ACC. But what they've done so far this season is Custer trying to go to work on Johnson, and he had him blocked. And finished inside by Ingram, but Johnson – better than 5.5 assist to turnover ratio. And he and Smith have combined so far this year to turn the ball over just about once every 20 minutes is their average. Here's a transition bucket for the Ramblers, and it's Jackson.
I tell you, every time you think NC State's going to really extend the lead, Loyola hangs in there, gets a steal and a layup. I tell you, they got a bunch of tough guys out there on Loyola, and they're just not going to roll over and make it easy for NC State.
Dorn. Boy, NC State is just too athletic on the offensive glass right now.
Again, credit Capita, keeping the ball alive, being very aggressive, going to the offensive glass and creating the opportunity for Dorn to come in for the slam.
Seeing the Wolfpack starting to gain a little more confidence here. That'll happen when you continually dunking the basketball, but Doyle pulls Loyola within one again.
There's got to be some kind of help coming from the weak side there. Dorn had a kind of size disadvantage. Somebody needed to come over and help out.
Poor pass from Capita. Richardson able to read it. Now Johnson saves the possession. 12 on the shot clock. And a deep two. Probably not the shot that they were looking for. Richardson all the way cross court. And Doyle gives the Ramblers the lead. Boy, just like what we saw in the first half, Chris, they are awfully efficient offensively.
Well, that's what you need from your leader, Doyle. A nice dribble penetration bucket. Capita with the miss. I tell you, Torin Dorn just goes and gets the ball. He finds a way to go and get it. Not a big guy, but great athlete.
So the lead changing hands back and forth.
Whoa.
Custer walked. That'll be a media timeout. Dennis Smith Jr. after the block from Abu This Pac team is dangerous in transition. Throw it down, young fella. Back here on the ACC Network Extra, Andrew Sanders and Chris Corciani. And Chris, this dunk by Dennis Smith Jr., we're going to go ahead and nominate it for the SportsCenter Top 10.
Tell you, you may see that again, but a great kick-ahead pass. That's what started it. And Markell, with eyes behind the back of his head, knew he was coming, and Dennis slammed it home.
Dennis Smith Jr., 21 points, 5 rebounds, 6 assists. There's still 11:35 to go, but I'm sure he's not too worried about those individual accomplishments right now because it's just a one-point ball game. Into the corner, there's Torin Dorm. Trying off-balance three and knocks it down.
Tell you, that was some place. Just to get that one off was special, but Torin, some athlete, really having a great early season. And I knew he was a good player, but I didn't know he was quite this good.
Doyle will drive right, had it poked away by Dennis Smith. And a little out of control. Offensive foul, and there is Richardson. Boy, he's had himself a good game. Doing some little things for Will. I know they changed the call. Inside the arc, they say. And we'll be able to see on this replay here, but, well, not from this angle.
Wow,
maybe so.
The defenders.
Yep, definitely
no
inside.
But great call.
Got his mostly inside, but got his feet just over the line. And Coach Gottfried, as you can see, he wants to know if they're shooting.
Well, yeah, I mean,
the officials are at the monitor right now.
You would think when the play is stopped, what happens, because they ended up making a layup, but the whistle was blown. I think it's just going to be NC State ball out of bounds.
Yep, and not all the way.
He's in the lane. Foul.
Yeah, so no, not a shooting foul. At least it shouldn't be.
Well, it's a shame because Doran had a wide open layup. Mm.
So the foul will go against Richardson. That is his third foul.
That was a good call.
And remember, he's been the one that has been, he's been the one as we get the explanation there, he's been guarding Dennis Smith Jr., so that could be big for Loyola.
Right. Yeah, no question. Good call, though. It's nice that they're able to go over to the monitor and take a look at it.
So Richardson in the restricted area. Abu will try a 15-footer. There is Richardson with the rebound. As you said, doing a good job boxing out, forcing NC State to go over the top of them and commit fouls in going for offensive rebounds.
Okay, they just have not gone away.
Away from the ball, and I think they got Capita here.
They got Ted in there wrestling and playing hard. I mean, give him a lot of credit. The kid's hungry, playing extremely hard. He just can't foul like that. I tell you, it reminds me a lot of a guy named Avi Lester, who I played with in the late 80s, 90s. Nobody played basketball any harder. It didn't matter if it was a game or practice.
Yeah.
Avi Lester wanted to take your head off. But Ted needs to just learn there's a time and place. You don't want to take that energy and aggression away from him, but he can't pick up silly fouls as well.
So Capita not having the impact that he had in the first game with the Wolfpack, as Hicks will check in. Skoknut dribbled it off his thigh momentarily, throws up a wild shot, and that's going to be an easy board for Dorn and the Wolfpack. A little pull up from the free throw line is good.
Great play, nice outlet pass again. NC State has the athletes this year that they can defend, rebound, and run. That's what Mark Gottfried was saying in practice.
Torin Dorn shooting nearly 70% from inside the arc this year, as Jackson might have walked with the basketball. Custer will knock down a three.
Custer makes him pay, but that was a bonus shot for him because that certainly looked like a travel underneath the basket.
It's 11 points for Custer. By the way, now 20 points for Torin Dorn. It's Dorn with 20, Henderson with 19, Smith with 21. Just a three-point Wolfpack advantage.
Every time you think Loyola is going to go away, they stay right there, tough as nails.
Skoknut to the basket.
That was a great dribble drive, but wasn't able to finish at the rim.
Tough shot for Dennis Smith. Loyola better than 50%. They're 8 of 14 from threes. We talked about in the beginning, this is a team that likes to shoot from downtown, and this is what we expected. If they could make a high percentage, you're going to be in the ball game.
And that's exactly what they've done. They shot the ball extremely well. Imagine if they weren't shooting the ball well.
Rejected by Hicks. And Dennis Smith on the other end. And you can just see anytime NC State gets a steal, a block, or a long rebound, it's trouble.
Like Dennis Smith is at its best when he has the ball and there's a defender or two back. He's very difficult to guard. He's explosive, electric, very strong.
Here's Richardson. And a little talking after that shot because Richardson remains hot from deep. And for Richardson, that's now 16 points on 6 of 11 shooting.
Love the way Richardson plays. Great shooter, but really plays hard. You got to love it.
Last touch by Henderson. Henderson disagrees. Loyola has cut it to just 2 here. Ben Richardson, 4 of 5 from deep. And again, it's Loyola. They're outside shooting. Keeping them in it now, 9 of 15. We'll hit the break. The Wolfpack up by 2. Tune in to SportsCenter at night with John Buchagross. He'll have all the college basketball, NBA, and NHL highlights, as well as the rest of the day in sports, with Boomer and Herm joining the show for NFL highlights and analysis. SportsCenter at night on ESPN, also streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. I'm Andrew Sanders here with Chris Corciani. Man, you know, we talked about how dangerous Loyola could be earlier. Since the start of 2012, Loyola has won 6 games against the Power 5 Big East or Mountain West, some of the higher caliber conferences in the country. That includes a win over Washington State earlier this season.
I'll tell you, they're playing extremely well. Custer's running the show, finding open men, and they're knocking down threes.
There he goes again. Andre Jackson gives Loyola the lead with 7:30 to go here in the second half. You know he's just not going to miss. You give him an open look.
He's 6 for 9, shooting a high percentage. I mean, going into the game shooting 79% is just amazing. And that's not off of one game.
Dennis Smith, he can do it all. We've seen him in transition, passing the ball, rebounding. He steps out and makes a big three and a clutch one to give NC State the lead back again.
You know, there's no doubt he's the leader of the Wolfpack. You know, when they need a big shot, the game's going south, he's going to be the one guy that's confident enough to take it.
Under 10 to shoot. Here's Ingram. There's Jackson, great position down low, and he's going to score that again. Anytime you can get that kind of position against a guy undersized compared to you like Terry Henderson.
Yeah, NC State needs to, as soon as he gets the ball, needs to run somebody at him, double team. But, you know, again, they've got such great shooters, that's a tough thing to do.
Jackson into double figures once again. Smith Jr. fading away. All tied at 71. Jackson, by the way, has 18 points.
You could see Coach Mosier wanted a offense called, wanted something set. Wants to get the ball to the guy that's shooting at a very high level.
Fans wanted to travel. Ingram in on Hicks, and he missed it.
Great defense by Hicks. Slid his feet, contested the shot without fouling, just a great defensive possession.
Dribbled into his chest, and I tell you what, Hicks awfully strong for a freshman, able to withstand it. The intensity in this one is picked up. Both teams starting to sense, hey, it's close, and it's getting later. Seven on the shot clock. Here's Henderson. And he chose not to go off glass.
Well, it wasn't able to finish.
Richardson finds Custer. He'll split two defenders. And had it somehow
couldn't
stay
finish.
Out.
Tell you what, a great drive by Custer. Split the defense, got all the way to the rim with his right hand and couldn't finish.
And that's going to go against Richardson. Now 4 on him. Again, he has drawn the difficult task of guarding Dennis Smith Jr.
He's had a big game. playing both ends of the court, the leader, a fighter. He won't be on that bench long.
And he yells as he goes over to the bench, hey, get a stop. We'll see if Loyola can do just that here in a 71 all game.
They got to be happy. 5 minutes to go, deadlocked.
Right where you want to be.
Just a great game.
Oh, Johnson nearly threw it down, had it knocked away.
Andrew, that's a point guard going up there trying to throw it back. It's amazing athlete, Markel Johnson, going to the offensive glass.
Nearly reversed that play from earlier when it was Johnson to Dennis Smith. Doyle with the runner. And the rebound will go to Johnson. NC State's going to call timeout.
Full.
And that will become the media timeout. So 71 all. Both of these teams off to a hot start this season. Loyola 5-1, NC State 4-1. And we'll take a break and be right back from Raleigh. NC State and Loyola all knotted up at 71 apiece. We just had the under four timeout because of the call timeout by Coach Godfrey. Here's a look at the big three for NC State and what they've done this afternoon. I mean, unbelievable job by Dennis Smith, Terry Henderson, and Torin Dorn. The issue for the Wolfpack, why they're in such a tight game, they haven't gotten really any contributions from anyone else.
I tell you, those three, Smith, Henderson, and Dorn, have really stepped up, played extremely well on the offensive end, shooting at a high efficiency. But yes, they need to get a boo. They need another scorer, especially somebody on the inside. And Abu's that guy. He's just not having one of his good games. Interesting, Loyola gets out of the man-to-man after that timeout, goes to a little zone.
Henderson will shoot over the zone and missed it front end. Loyola with the basketball and a chance to take the lead here under 4 minutes in the PNC Arena.
It's a great call coming out of that timeout.
And Jackson walked. You see what they're trying to do? They feel like he can score over Henderson down low.
No question. They went right at him. Great change. Let's see what they do. They're going to stay in the zone. They want to try to contain Dennis Smith's penetration. Smart play call by Coach Mosier.
They work the ball around into the middle. It's Johnson. And tipped in by Abu, and that's what I was talking about when I said almost no contributions.
Yep.
There were just 6 points. Abu has four, but no points from Kapita, no points from Anya. So the big guys for the Pack, they need Abu here to step up in the late game situation.
Ooh.
Custer able to find Richardson. Tried to get it back to him, and it was picked away by Dennis Smith, all the way to the rack.
Tell you, he's something else. Great defensive play on one end. Goes all the way down to the bucket.
He's so athletic, Chris, that it doesn't really seem like he's even running that fast, and yet he always beats his man down the floor.
There's no question. You know, we haven't seen an athlete on the basketball court like Dennis Smith Jr. here in Raleigh in years. Gets his hands on a lot of balls on the defensive end. And there he just flies down, a great finisher at the rim.
I mean, you could see the effort from Richardson right there. He was trying to run his hardest, and Smith with the basketball, just able to beat him down the floor. The line for Smith right now, 28 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists, and 3 steals to go along with
it. You know, the funny thing is it's a quiet 28. You know, he hasn't forced shots. He lets the game come to him. It's amazing he puts up those numbers. He's logging a lot of minutes. But I like to see him on the defensive end like he did on that last play, get his hand on the ball, create the action, and fly down the court and finish. He can finish with the best of them.
Under 3 to play, and this building has got some more energy after that little sequence. The Abu offensive rebound, the tip in, and then the Smith steal and score. But Loyola has not gone away all afternoon. big possession for the Ramblers here. And it's Smith all over Richardson. Finds Custer. Baseline, only eight to shoot. He'll drive it in there. It's a three from Richardson. Front iron missed it. And the ball falls to Ingram, still alive. Underneath, he throws it up. And a foul will be called.
Boy, that ball bounced the right way there for Loyola. It looked like NC State was going to have the ball. And all of a sudden, Ingram comes up with it and is fouled by Dennis Smith.
Just the first foul on Dennis Smith. Ingram will go to the line. He's a junior from Chicago. Went to Simeon High School where he won a state championship. Jabari Parker was on that team.
And some great players out of Simeon in Chicago. You know, we were talking about this a little bit earlier.
Yeah.
Ben, which you've seen, the 30 for 30. Nick Anderson, who I played with the Orlando Magic. But that's a factory, Simeon in Chicago.
Ingram makes the free throw. Cuts it to two. You can't forget about Derrick Rose as well, also going to Simeon. You know when you come out of Simeon, that's some good basketball.
Derrick Rowe, wow, that's big time. Ben Wilson, wow. They go back man-to-man, and they're going to have to try to contain Dennis's dribble penetration.
Again, it's Custer now on Smith because Richardson has the four fouls. Only five on the shot clock. Johnson's got to go. Deep three. Oh, he nearly banked it in. And there's an offensive rebound, Malik Abu.
Well, you got to love a guy that's struggling, not having a great offensive game, comes up with a huge offensive rebound a couple plays before, came up with a big-time tip.
Gets the feed back. What a dish and a finish from Abu.
I tell you, I thought he got hit on the hand, too, but a great dish by Dennis Smith. And Abu here is making his imprint here late in the game.
And here's Johnson with the steal. He's fouled by Custer. Boy, Chris, NC State, that might have been the best play that they've run all afternoon, and it comes in crunch time. And then the freshman Johnson forcing the turnover.
I tell you, Markel, here you see the great pass by Dennis Smith. Slips the screen, and Abu finishes at the rim. But a great defensive play by Markel Johnson. Very quick hands. Gets the strip of Custer and gets fouled.
Dennis Smith, almost an impossible shot, and it was a quick one, so Richardson boards it up. Four to go, and Johnson is going to be called for a foul. Mark Gottfried and this crowd are incensed.
Oh, I'm not sure.
Looked like
about
he had
that
it again,
one.
Partner.
I'd like to see that one. Ooh. Tell you, very, very unfortunate for Markel Johnson. But it gives Loyola life with a minute 13 to go, only down four. These guys have had the opportunity to go away, and they certainly haven't.
They couldn't have called it when he tipped the ball away. It was kind of reaching around afterwards. But still, didn't look like a whole lot there. Both teams with five fouls, by the way. Under a minute to go. Baseline spin from Doyle. Oh, and if he had gotten that, he could have cut it to one.
You know, again, they're seeing an advantage with Terry Henderson down on the low block, and they're going right at him. And help needs to come a little sooner. Doyle's a little bigger, a little stronger than Terry down there on the low post.
And this is who Loyola wants at the free throw line. 84%, and he rolls in the first.
He's certainly the leader of the team, but they've got really nice balanced scoring from Custer, Richardson, Doyle, and Jackson today, and that's always nice to have.
Doyle makes the two pressure free throws. And just a two-point contest.
Yeah. Coach Gottfried calling out a play. He wants a set play here because this could be the biggest offensive set that they've run all game.
Smith to Henderson. They get it inside. Immediately the double team comes. He passes out of it. Good ball movement from the pack. Now Johnson's going to look to attack, and he was fouled. Now that's the sixth foul on Loyola. But what it'll do is reset the shot clock here.
Yep.
So it goes from 5 seconds to now 30, just a two-second differential. And immediately Loyola. Did they call timeout? The foul was called on the floor. We didn't think it was a shooting foul. Both coaches talking things over with their group. That's five fouls. And remember, they changed this last year, that after five fouls, you can't take quite as much time as you used to.
Right. I mean, it used to be a joke. People would just use it as a timeout. I'll tell you, Markell Johnson's there.
So Richardson is fouled out with that foul on Johnson. And that is, of course, a big loss for Loyola with his 16 points. But now,
they're going to have to foul. I mean, they're going to have to foul. They can't wait and let it go down to under 2 seconds.
I don't know what they're waiting for here. Smith's just going to pull it out.
They've got a foul.
And now Custer reaches in. And that's the fourth foul on Custer.
I was a little surprised they didn't foul. You know, they wasted about 12, 13 seconds when you knew they had to, just to try to extend the game.
1-1 for Smith, and he makes the first. Smith has been very clutch at the free throw line, 87% coming into this one. And he's got 30 points for NC State.
Wow, big free throws by the freshman. Now they just need to play solid defense. And Loyola's going to have to look for a quick two, which they get.
Boy, Milton Doyle, he can get up and down the floor in a blink. And Loyola will want another timeout here, 10.4 remaining. And again, just a two-point game on the drive by Doyle.
Great drive by Doyle, but somebody has to make him change his direction, therefore, you know, take a little bit more time. You know, Abu's got to be, you can't let a guy with a straight dribble drive all the way to the bucket. You got to make him take a little bit of time. Now you got Loyola down two with 10 seconds. You know, they're going to have to foul right away. You certainly don't want to foul Dennis Smith, but they may not be able to choose exactly who they want to.
Loyola, the team that, you know, they're 5-1 right now, but they went 4-0 over the summer on their trip to Spain. And as we see with teams that are able to take that international trip, able to take one once every 4 years, they always seem a little bit more ready to play at the beginning of the year, and it makes sense.
Yeah, it's such an advantage for teams to be able to go overseas. Like you mentioned, they're able to do it once every 4 years, but it gives them a chance to know one another off the court and also on the court. But you know, they also have those transfers that are mature players. I mean, this is a team that's really going to challenge in the Missouri Valley. And coming on the road here to Raleigh, you know, they've shown a lot.
Loyola is 11-42 all-time against the ACC. Their last win, and again, this is against current members of the ACC. Their last win against an ACC member came against Notre Dame, but before the Irish were in the conference, they came on January 24th, 1994. Dennis Smith Jr., 22 shots, 30 points, 7 assists, and 6 rebounds. But right now, free throw shooting is going to be so crucial.
Yeah, I would get Abu away from the ball. He's the one guy out there. If I'm Loyola, I'm trying to foul.
They get it into Terry Henderson. And the clock will stop with 8.5 seconds left. Henderson, again, one of the big leaders of this team. They were pressured by Georgia Southern in the opener, and it was Henderson that they leaned on to make some pressure free throws, and that should be 5 fouls on Custer now.
Right, Henderson's had a great start to the year. He does a lot of different things. The one thing I was talking to Mark Godfrey about was, I said, what's the most surprising thing to you so far in the early going? And he said it was our three-point shooting. He said, I knew we were going to be a good three-point shooting team, but I didn't think we'd shoot it at the level we have early in the season.
Just 8 fouls on Loyola. So this is a 1-1 for Henderson, and it rattled out. Chance for Loyola.
Got to get back, find the shooters.
Doyle had it stripped by Johnson. He just has a knack to get in there. That's the third strip we've seen here in crunch time.
Tell you, biggest play of the game right here, made on the defensive end. Tell you, Coach Mosier over there doesn't think it was a clean strip. We'll get another look at it right here.
Markell Johnson.
Markell moving along. Ooh, Tell you what.
He certainly reached in. It looked like he got part of his arm.
Got a little bit of the arm there. That may have been Coach Mosier certainly didn't agree with the referee there.
And he misses the free throw. So same situation. It's good if it goes. And NC State will hang on to beat Loyola by a 79-77 mark. But the Wolfpack fans here in Raleigh let out a huge sigh of relief because these Ramblers push their Wolfpack to the brink.
No question. I tip my hat to both teams, but Loyola came in here, played hard, well coached by Coach Mosier, and a hard-fought loss. NC State, give them a lot of credit for falling behind early, staying the course, jumping on the back of Dennis Smith Jr. Just a good performance by both teams.
Dennis Smith, a career-high 30 points tonight on 13 of 22 shooting, 7 assists, 6 rebounds. So that will do it for our great crew. And my partner, Chris Corciani, I'm Andrew Sanders, saying so long from Raleigh, where the final score is NC State 79, Loyola 77. To watch this entire game on replay, as well as other games on our family of ESPN networks, log on to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. This has been a presentation of ESPN.
Wow, I tell you what,